What's up everyone? In this lesson, we will learn how to do seamless transitions within DaVinci Resolve and Fusion. So this is the sample footage we will work with. You might be wondering, why is there a dot on the phone itself? This is just for the tracking. So we will track our screen right here, and then we will zoom into the screen as a transition. So let's go ahead and open this up in Fusion. Hit Control Spacebar on the keyboard, and then type in tracker. With this tracker, we will follow our object, which is the tracking marker right here, track it forwards and backwards. And you can see now this is tracking perfectly onto our screen. The DaVinci Resolve tracker will work better when you use a good tracking point. Go to your keyframes tab here on the top and make sure we have zoom to fit. So you see all the different keyframes right here. And then also open up your spline tool. And let's do the same here. And we want to look for some spikes. So for example here, and that's because the tracker skips one frame and is not in the center. So we can simply delete this, select it, hit delete, and then it will correct itself and will be much cleaner. And one thing we can also do to make it more smooth is select all the keyframes and hit S on the keyboard to smooth it out. And now we're gonna test how good our tracking really is. So add another node called XF for transform. And then in the transform node, we have an option called pivot. So we can change the pivot point of our transform node. So let's say we placed it here in the center of the screen. When we change the size, we will zoom into that pivot point. If it's just on the center, like so, it will zoom into the center. So with that in mind, I will link our pivot point onto the tracker. And to do so, we go to your pivot point, right click, then connect to, and position. And right now we don't see anything because our footage is just on a tripod, but once we transform it and scale it, it will follow the phone and it's stabilized onto the tracking point. It's a simple technique, but it's so effective and you can use it for a lot of different ways. Also to stabilize your footage. So go ahead and change your size again to 1. And the next step is isolating the screen. And for this, we have a green screen, so that makes it a bit easier. We just need to key out the green screen and then get rid of the dot. So now we will add another node called key, delta keyer. Add it to the pipeline. So click and hold your background color and then just select the color on the screen. And let's also add another background behind our screen. So right click on your delta keyer and then add a background. And then in the merge, go to your operator and set it to under. So now it's gonna be under. But you will see there's a lot of noise, and that's because the keyer is not refined yet. So let's select our keyer and go to your alpha channel right here. And now we see all the imperfections on our alpha. In the delta keyer, go to your matte tab, then clip the values low and high, just like this. So you only see the screen. And now we see it's much cleaner and we have a perfect mask of our screen. You can also change the color of your background to white or something like blue. Now we need to get rid of the tracking marker, which is actually pretty easy. Just go to your presets here on the top and let's select ellipse right here. And then we have a mask, so let's scale it down and make sure it's covering the tracking marker like this. And then the only thing we need to do is go to your center, which is the position of the ellipse itself, and let's right click and also connect it to the position of our tracking pad. So now it will follow the same position as our tracking marker, then we will apply it to the delta cure. So really important here is that you right click on your output and then hover over the delta cure, then let go, and you will see different options. We can use this as a clean plate, garbage mat, solid mat. We will use garbage mat. So that will create a mask on the delta cure, and there we go. So now we isolated the screen in a really clean and clever way with not too many notes. Now the second step is transitioning into the screen. If you want to learn more about visual effects, I have an online community on school called the Visual Effects Room. In here, I will post all my project files, lessons and everything. In the classroom, you will find a DaVinci Resolve visual effects crash course. You will also learn some CGI and the latest AI tools. It's currently at $5 a month because I just want to help as many people as possible. We currently have about 100 members and it's growing. So if you want to support the channel, go ahead and check it out. Now back to the video. For this example, I will just use a star background like this. So we transition into the stars. And let's add the stars onto our merge instead of our background. Like this, and now preview the merge. We can also add a transform onto our stars and scale it down a bit. Now it's sitting behind the screen just like this, and you can also choose to use the tracker on the transform, so that way it will move with the position. But for this example, we will just leave it as it is. Now to zoom into the screen, we will just use our transform node we created before. But there's a small issue because when we change the scale, you can see it's not really responding as it should be. And that's because the order is not correct. So now we are scaling, but the ellipse is not scaling with it. So instead of doing it before, we will do it after the delta cure. So that way, it's not affecting the ellipse. So if you ever run into issues, just double check your transform and the position in your node tree. So I will start from here and then right on frame 100, I will set a keyframe on the center and also the size. And then move forward a few frames. And then here we're gonna zoom into our screen. There's a limit, so I will exceed that limit to, let's say, 20. And now we're fully covering the screen, just like this. So go to your keyframes and also the spline, and only select the size. And here we have our keyframes. Let's hit S on the keyboard to smooth it out. And now with these handles, we can also change the curve. So let's ease it in a little bit more. Just like this, extending the handles. And let's also go to the settings of the transform and add some motion blur. And one thing left to do is scaling the stars so it fits the frame after the transition. So let's go to our stars. So right from this point, we will set a keyframe at the center and size, and then go forward and then change the position to the original, just like so, and also smooth out those keyframes. Then go to the middle of the transition and also place a keyframe for the scale. This. Then you should have something like this. Super easy, super smooth, and so versatile.